What up gamers, I'm Sir Mav and welcome to another Destiny 2 video. Today I'm covering the topic of weapon reload perks. Come on, you know you uncovered new weapons within Destiny 2, especially with the ease of unlocking these time loss bounty weapons right now, and you see its perks and wonder, what's the god role of this weapon? Of course, you could just hop on the internet and type in light.gg and find out, but that's not why you're here watching this video right now. You want to have a better understanding of which perks are the best for you. Well, I've already covered the weapon damage perks within Destiny, link down in the description box below if you want to check out that video. But now, to maximize DPS even further, we also need to deep dive into the reload perks you can find on the sought-out weapons of Destiny 2. The reload perks we are looking into today are Outlaw, Rapid Hit, Feeding Frenzy, Underdog, Threat Detector, Field Prep, and a unique one that came in with Season of Dawn called Elemental Capacitor. Now, Elemental Capacitor is unique in that you supposedly can only acquire the reload perk while running the Solar class on your character with an Elemental Capacitor weapon equipped. But for the life of me, I couldn't enable this perk to proc with any of the time loss weapons from the Sundial and Obelisk bounties where you find this perk. Not sure if it was a bug or what, but I tested it in multiple ways and I never saw any difference in any weapon's reload speed during my tests. So ultimately, the conclusion is that this perk is useless over any other choices, and I would place this one in particular at the bottom of your list to acquire on any given weapon within Destiny 2. But regardless of that one anomaly, I ran tests with all these perks mentioned on 21 unique weapons within Destiny 2 to find out which one you should seek out on a weapon if it's an available perk on that weapon. Now if you're quick, you'll notice that even the same weapon will have a different base reload speed. This is also because the mag perk on the weapon also impacts reload speed depending on which one you equip, if there's a choice of course. So just throwing that out there before we start if someone happens to call out the different base reload speeds on the same weapon in the sheet I just showed you on screen. Now what we're looking for here in these tests is how much of an impact does an active reload perk have to your weapon's base reload speed. Then we'll get into whether or not this reload perk is the best based on its ease of use to proc and its overall improvement to the weapon's reload speed. But this will all be discussed afterwards. First, let's get into the results from testing. First off, going into this, I thought I was going to see a clear percentage improvement in reload speed across the board, no matter the weapon's archetype for each reload perk. For instance, if I proc'd Outlaw, whether on a sidearm or sniper rifle, we would see a clear, say, 25% increase in reload speed during the duration of Outlaw. But after testing and seeing all the results, boy was I wrong. The only thing that seemed to reign true with this theory was the duration of a reload perk. For instance, if you have a sidearm with Outlaw, the perk would last 5 seconds compared to a pulse rifle where the perk would last 4.5 seconds. All the sidearms I tested had the same duration for Outlaw of 5 seconds and the same percentage increase of 30% compared to their base reload speeds. This was also the same for Feeding Frenzy when I tested out the Cold Front and Recluse. Both weapons are classified as submachine guns. Both had the same duration of 4.5 seconds and an increase of roughly 47% when the perk was active. After analyzing the data, there was a 2% difference between the increases, but given the difference is so minute, the increases are figuratively the same. But when you changed weapon archetypes, the percentage increases varied widely between each archetype tested. And it wasn't always the case that the same weapon archetypes would see the same increases across the board. So it seems that really, these perks are going to be catered to each weapon themselves. But after these tests, I can definitely paint you a better picture as to which reload perk will provide you with the most benefits. The first three we're going to look at is Outlaw, Rapid Hit, and Feeding Frenzy, as these are the only three with time limits to them once proc'd. For Outlaw, its duration will last anywhere from 4.5 to 5 seconds I mentioned earlier, and the increases in reload speed ranged anywhere from 26% all the way up to 67%. Sniper rifles, hand cannons, and pulse rifles seem to gain the most benefit from this perk, as within the weapons tested I saw over 50% increases with these weapon archetypes. The Feeding Frenzy perk showed very similar results to Outlaw with the same duration and a range between 25 and 53%. Submachine guns and pulse rifles seem to gain the most out of Feeding Frenzy, averaging around the 50% mark in reload increases. But if a weapon has Rapid Hit available on it, it's a must over the other two mentioned perks, as Outlaw and Feeding Frenzy require a kill to proc them. Rapid Hit only requires you to maintain precision hits on your target, and it comes in a multiples of 5, which is not at all hard to do with any rapid fire pulse rifle or hand cannon. Especially when even the times 1 benefit of Rapid Hit already gives you anywhere from 35 to 39% increase in your reload speed. At times 5, you're looking at anywhere from a 47 to 76% increase in the weapon's reload speed, which is a huge increase in a weapon's DPS and allows you to get back in the action faster. But do keep in mind that the perk only lasts anywhere from 1.5 to 2.2 seconds once initiated, so you will have to be quick to reload to get the most out of this reload perk. The next reload perks do not have a duration limit tied to them, but will require certain circumstances to initiate them. The best of these, in my opinion, is Field Prep, which is procced by just simply crouching. You don't have to kill an enemy, no hitting a precision shot, just a press of the button and the perk is active. Plus, you get the benefit of extra reserves for your weapon. The perk also so happens to have one of the best increases in reload speed, ranging from 27% to 41% increases, with shotguns seeing the least amount of benefits from this perk compared to other weapons. The reload perk Underdog has similar increases, ranging from 22 to 47%, but the downside is that this perk requires you to be at critical health for it to be active, which is really only useful when you're utilizing the Season of Dawn mod, Protective Light, on your armor. And let's be honest here, there's more benefit to a perk that can be procced while at full health than utilizing one that requires you to be in the line of fire. The last reload perk is Threat Detector, which requires enemies to be within the vicinity in order for this perk to proc. But it does go up to times 2, and with some good increases ranging from 7 to 32% with one enemy near you, and 8 to 44% when you have two or more within the vicinity. Given that the 7 to 8% was for shotguns, I would steer clear of this perk on that specific weapon archetype. But still, it's a decent perk to have within a PvE setting against rank and file enemies of Destiny 2. So out of all these discussed, Rapid Hit and Field Prep are going to likely be your best options to utilize on any weapon where available. Not only do you see substantial increases from these perks alone, but they are also the easiest to proc compared to the other reload perks. But even after these tests, these are not the only perks you should consider when thinking about reload speeds for your weapon. There are other perks which I'll classify as instant ammo perks, as this is because once you activate them, your weapon will gain instant ammo to the mag. While the auto-loading holster is sort of instant, but it's really only a beneficial perk if the time it takes to reload while holstered is shorter than the actual reload speed. But at the same time, it allows you to keep firing with another weapon while you're waiting for the holstered weapon to reload. So along with auto-loading holster, we have Demolitionist, Grave Robber, Subsistence, Slideshot, Slideways, and Pulse Monitor. All these perks will allow you to either partially or fully reload your weapon after initiating the perk. The most beneficial is going to be Demolitionist, as this perk triggers a full reload after throwing your grenade, but also grants you grenade energy when making kills with that same weapon. Special ammo weapons also grant more grenade energy per kill than primary ammo weapons, so definitely one of my favorites to run on any weapon. Slideshot is also one you'll need to look out for on a shotgun, as this not only partially reloads your mag from reserves, but also improves range and stability of that weapon. Slideways is exactly the same, but instead of range, it boosts handling, which is okay but not as useful as range on most weapons, especially shotguns. Subsistence is another good one, but the downside is you'll run out of ammo fast in PvE, as your reserves are basically reduced by half from what you would normally have for that weapon. The last two, Grave Robber and Pulse Monitor, are okay, but the other perks are way better options in my opinion. For one, Grave Robber requires a melee kill to activate and only partially fills your magazine, so really only viable against minor and rank and file mobs within Destiny 2. Pulse Monitor is in the same boat as Underdog in that you have to be critically wounded for it to proc, which means no shield and in the red, and even then, the perk only gives you partial ammo. So this is definitely a no-go by my standards as a perk you would want on any one of your weapons. With that, gamers, this was all of the weapon reload perks in a full, analytical data-aligned nutshell. And I'm not done yet. There are still other factors to consider in a weapon's reload speed, from specific class abilities, exotic armor, and armor mods. But for the sake of this being a timely video, that's for another time and another Destiny 2 video. What are your thoughts on the data I laid out for you today, and is there any go-to perks that you always look for when considering a weapon within Destiny 2? Let me know down in the comments section below. But with that, if you enjoyed the content, drop this video a like and tap fire subscribe for more insights into Destiny 2. Until next time, gamers, this is Sir Mav, signing off.